Hello there, beautiful. How are you doing today? Welcome back to my channel. Have you ever found yourself asking what you'd get if you crossed over Rune Factory with Bravely Default? No, neither have I, actually. But here we are with Harvest Stella, the newest game released from Square Enix, an RPG with farming sim elements and brand new to Switch and Steam for us to have a look at today in today's video review. So I've been very fortunate and Square Enix has gifted me a copy of the game so that I can play through it and share my thoughts with you all. So if you'd like to know more about Harvest Stella and ultimately whether I think it's worth picking up for you, especially in this day and age where there's so many massive games coming out and not a lot of time to play them, then stay tuned and keep on watching. Of course, don't forget to check out all of my social media links down in the description box below. You can find me streaming all sorts of different things over on Twitch, including Harvest Stella. We've been playing this on stream the last couple of days, and therefore being able to showcase my thoughts with you guys and you guys sharing your opinions with me, and I'd love to hear from you all on opinions of any games that I might be playing, so definitely come down and follow me on Twitch as well. Over on Patreon, I do always shout out one of my patrons every time I release a new video, and today that person is going to be Goose, who has been a very, very big supporter of mine in the past, and I'm extremely grateful to them and to all of my patrons, as without you guys, I wouldn't be able to do what I continue to do, and I'm very, very grateful. And if you'd like to join in supporting the channel and getting title cards made for you, just like Goose has here, then perhaps you'd like to consider clicking on the link in the description box as well. So a quick disclaimer here, I have played the game for about 10 to 12 hours and have gone way beyond where the demo lets up, and if you are interested in trying the game out for yourself, there is a demo on the Nintendo eShop and over on Steam that you can try out that takes you through a lot of the base game mechanics if you wanted to give this game a go. But honestly, 10 to 12 hours is not nearly enough for you to really dive in and take in all of the splendor and all of the, like, what the game has to offer, because there's any game like this is very, very large, and with Square Enix releasing quite so many titles recently, this is very much a first impressions review. But as time goes on, I'm hoping to spend more time with the game and bring you even more thoughts as time progresses. Between Dio Field Chronicle, Valkyrie Elysium, Tactics Ogre Reborn, Star Ocean the Divine Force, and of course Harvest Stella, there is a lot on any Square Enix fan's plate right now, so do forgive me if maybe some of these thoughts are retconned later down the line. So for those of you who don't know what Harvest Stella is, Harvest Stella is the newest JRPG from Square Enix that features a farming simulator set of gameplay mechanics that serve to push the story along with the RPG elements of the game. It crosses over combat, sort of exploration, dungeon crawling, and of course the farming sim aspects. If you're looking for a game that's like your new Stardew Valley, which is very much considered the gold standard for the life sim style farming simulators, this is probably not going to be the game for you, because as far as I can tell, there aren't any romance options. Again, this is 10 to 12 hours in, and having spoken to other people that have played the game, there don't seem to be much. The character customization is quite limited, but I will say, one thing I will shout Square Enix out for here is the option to choose a non-binary gender for your character, which I think is a wonderful thing in terms of representation, and I'd love to see more companies doing this in the future. And then the story is fairly formulaic as RPG goes, certainly in this day and age where you are a character that has lost their memory, turned up in a strange world, and you've managed to survive this phenomenon, or a season called Quietus, which is a season of death where any sort of, dust particles that permeate the air can instantly kill you, and you've managed to survive it, and people don't know how or why. So basically you're going through the story to explore why this might be the case, why these characters called Omens, which are humanoid creatures, some of which are human as you see very much in the start of the game, and also the Seas Lights, which are crystals, giant crystals, which look beautiful by the way, off in the distance to your various towns, and piecing together the mysteries of what goes on with those. From there, the story kind of just snowballs very, very quickly. Like, every other cutscene that you see is introducing so many new characters. There's a unicorn that turns up, there's a girl who's in one of these omen armors, there's, the doctor is coming down who saves you from the beginning. Turns out there's way more to her than meets the eye. Basically, there's just layers upon layers upon layers upon layers of various character arcs and things where, honestly, it starts to get a little bit hard to follow, but the actual kind of progression of the game feels so natural and fun that I can see past it, and it doesn't really matter to me. It would have been nice to have seen some voice acting across the cutscenes, although honestly, I feel the same way about Harvestella than I do a lot of Square Enix's more recent releases. It feels like it's harkening back to kind of late PS2, early PS3 era, where the games are at the forefront of the RPG narrative rather than the actual narrative of the story itself. So this is giving me a lot of Dark Cloud, Dark Chronicle vibes, where you're going through the dungeons to collect the pieces you need, finish side quests, and accumulate money so that you can then further your farm later on. But as, honestly, at this point in the game that I'm at, the farming aspect of Harvestella does actually seem to be taking quite a heavy backseat in favor of the dungeon crawling RPG elements to it, which was not what I expected, but quite welcome. I used Bravely Default as my point of comparison at the very start of this video for two very poignant reasons. The first of which is its visual style. There's a lot to love about the visual style of this game. Like, the vistas are very colourful, the lighting is stunning. I played the Steam version of this game and it ran completely beautifully, although my capture probably isn't showing that off very well right now. And on my Steam Deck as well, it also ran beautifully with all of these vibrant colours. The art direction of the characters is great and definitely gave me reminiscence of the Bravely Default series and that style of RPG. But not only that, but a lot of the gameplay mechanics actually seem to draw from Bravely Default as well. As you're progressing through sort of the dungeons and the RPG portions of the game, you'll discover a job system, which is paramount to anything Square Enix does, whether it be Final Fantasy, Bravely Default, or otherwise. And there's a lot to like here as well. As you progress, you earn more jobs from your party members. You do have a party in this, which I don't think Rune Factory typically does. I haven't played a lot of Rune Factory, just as an FYI. And then you pull together these characters and they grant their jobs onto you, and you can switch jobs on the fly whilst also taking down enemies so that you're looking for their weaknesses and what weapons they might be weak to, what elements they might be weak to, things like that, so that you're able to kind of swap and change using various cooldowns on the fly. And it honestly, after a while, felt really cohesive and fun. Now, the main portion of the game that people may find not to their taste is the way that time management works in it. Like any farming sim, everything takes time and you have to return to your bed within a certain period of time, otherwise you become exhausted and you rubbish for the next day, like real life. But here, everything takes time, where you'll find that there's a lot of things like crafting or cooking or even just certain interactables in the overworld and in dungeons that suddenly you lose an hour of your day because you've sat there rifling through branches to get to a shiny thing behind a tree. And that to me feels a little bit weird. Like, it's definitely not to the point of egregious where it was really bothering me and took me out of the game, but it's definitely something that people will want to bear in mind. You're gonna have to kind of figure out what your priorities are. Are you gonna progress the main story? Do you wanna focus on your farming aspects? Which, again, you can't do a huge amount of, certainly not at the start of the game. After sort of chapter 3, which is a much larger chapter than the two before it, you'll find that things open up pretty heavily, but it definitely takes a little while to get there. It's also very much worth pointing out the one aspect of games that you can always rely on Square Enix to deliver on, and that's music. The soundtrack to Harvestella by Goshina is stunning. Like, from the second I loaded up the title screen and I heard the main theme of the game, I just was like, oh, okay, we're in for something here. And I was not wrong. The dungeon themes are fabulous. The overworld theme is fabulous. The town themes are beautiful. All of the music in this game absolutely drew me in, and I was extremely impressed in every hour I've spent playing this game so far. One thing that really surprised me about the story and the narrative when it came to this game, certainly in the more minutiae parts of it, so the side quests, things like that, is how surprisingly dark in tone it is for such a game that looks quite twee on a surface level. Like, it's farming and you're going out and exploring and this and the other. And then you come across a child who's run away from home because he thinks his parents don't love him anymore. And then you go back to a house where a woman is pining and cleaning up her house for her husband or her lover that she doesn't think is coming home and everyone thinks is a ghost. it gets pretty dark pretty quickly when it comes to sort of the side quests and stuff like that. Now, one thing I like to do when I'm looking at a game, certainly with a new release, is look at kind of the buzz around it. And I thought I'd do that with Harvest Stella here. So I've pulled up Reddit and YouTube here to see how active its community is. And the subreddit for Harvest Stella has 2.9 thousand members, 193 online right now. And it's got some activity, so like 8 hours, 7 hours, 10 hours ago, 7 hours, 3 hours. So obviously the game having just come out, this is going to be generating some buzz for people who haven't played it before. And then over on YouTube, there are quite a few videos being made for it, and some of them are doing quite well in terms of views. Like this one here has 120,000, this one has 50,000, the launch trailer has 60,000. 43,000 views from Arix Gaming, who obviously a very big YouTuber doing well with that. So there is quite a lot going on around what is happening with Harvest Stella. I wouldn't say that it's going to be like one of the big releases of the year, like, you know, sort of your God of Wars or even Final Fantasy 16 and stuff like that when that comes around. But it is nice to see that the game is getting a community built up for it over the course of time. I think that the fact that this game lacks co-op, which is something I probably should have mentioned earlier, is probably to its detriment here, where, you know, if a game like that, people want Stardew Valley basically, and if a game doesn't feature the ability to play with others in a farming simulator, then a lot of people will see that as a negative. I, however, don't, because I don't think this game is comparable to Stardew Valley. I think there's a lot of people out there that are very unfairly comparing it to games like that, and honestly, I do think that games like Dark Cloud, Dark Chronicle, Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles are much better comparisons with it, certainly because the game is more focused on the RPG element than the farming sim element. So now let's ask the big question, should you pick up Harvest Stella? Now, I've only played 10 to 12 hours of it, as I said earlier, so I don't feel that my opinion here is completely absolute, but after 10 to 12 hours, I can give a pretty good impression as to what I think I've enjoyed about the game and what I feel others might as well. So I think, first things first, Harvest Stella is stunning. Both audio and visual, I think, are beautiful. I haven't played this on the Switch. I've only played this on Steam and on the Steam Deck, and it looks stunning on there, and the music was to die for. The actual gameplay, I think this game is going to be better suited to people who are looking for an ARPG, particularly an old school one. So I've given comparisons to other games and like already in this review, but those kinds of things I think will work really well for you if you enjoy those kinds of things. The farming simulator aspect of it absolutely does feel like it takes a back seat to the narrative, to the gameplay of the actual dungeon crawler aspect of the game. So if you're looking for a life sim, you probably won't find it here. The character creation tools are very limited, and you know, there's no romance options as far as I can find, which I know is important to a lot of players. I am not one of these players that goes looking for that kind of thing, but there are a lot of people out there who are, and so if that's something you're looking for, you're not going to find it here. But the story, while it looks very surface level formulaic and a bit twee and a bit cute, it layers up really quickly to the point where I found it a little overwhelming to begin with. But over the course of time, I can see how it's going to expand, and I really came to enjoy what I saw with it. And the job system that's being used here in terms of combat, I found used very uniquely, and just it really added to my enjoyment of the game. So if you're looking for a more traditional style of ARPG with a secondary life sim element, then you've got a lot to love here. If you are looking for a farming simulator, this probably isn't the game for you. So that's all for my review on Harvest Stella. As I said, it's an early review. I'm hoping to spend some more time with it, and I may make a second video adjusting my thoughts later. If that's something that you want to see, then definitely comment down below and let me know what you think. Are you playing Harvest Stella? What have you thought of it so far? Again, let us know in the comments, or come and find me on Twitch and let's chat about it. It'd be lovely to hear from you. It does look like there is a very sort of bustling community for it right now, so if you want to jump in on the hype, then get in on it. Absolutely. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and click the bell for notifications on any other videos that I might be making. And I will see you next time. I hope you have a lovely day, beautiful, and I'll see you then. Take care.